Hello student, yesterday we saw the point of image and forms. So if in image we already saw the topic which how we include that image in our web pages, correct? So for that we use the image background tag, or another tag is the image img tag or map tag. So today we will see forms. So what is a form? Form is a typical form is a typical layout on the web page by which a user can interact with the web page. So in HTML, form is a part of document which may have a general content, special elements known as a control. Like we can add the text boxes, text field, check boxes, submit buttons, some radio buttons also. So usually complete a form by modifying this element. So modification is important, and you including the modification, you entering some text, selecting control like checkboxes, etc. So before the submitting this form to next page, or we can say processing on this web page, the data is posted to an application like CGI, ASP script or PHP script, etc. So this application will be perform essential processing in the accept data based on defined business logic. Which business logic you use for this web page or that applications, correct? So for your form, for your website, you can use this form function, this form element. And HTML forms are generally necessary when we want to accept some data from website visitor, correct? So for the email account from credit card form, where we may like to accept the information like you client name, client email ID, address, phone number, gender, etc. Correct. So form property with the document objects contain the on array all the form defines within the that document. So this is the syntax of the form. Form action, script URI, method get and post. Okay. So form element like input buttons, and that this is the part of the form. Okay. So within that form opening tag and closing tag, you can write those elements in that form. For example, you can see here form name equal to my form is my form name, action server ph.php. Okay, one second. Okay, method get and target is blank. Okay, so some attributes are present here. First attribute is action. It specifies the URL where the form should be submitted. Okay, second is a method. It specifies the HTTP method such get and post. So get method is a default append of the form data to URL in name value pair, URL name also and value also. So method which is will be upload the data, and a common method used are get and post. So you already know what is a get method and post method. So let me explain first get method. So get in the get method, after the submission of form, the form value will be visible in the address bar of the new browser tab. And this, and it has a limited size, like its size is a 3000 character, and it's only helpful for the non-secure data, not for the sensitive information. And when you use the post method, after the submitting that form, the form value will not be visible in the address bar of the main new browser data, correct? So in a browser tab, it's visible in a get method. It's append from the data inside the body of HTTP request. It has no size limitation, as I told, get method has an limitations with 3000 character, but in post method there is no limitation. And this method does not support a bookmark the result, correct? So this is the get method. Default append the from data in URL name, and for post method send the data from HTTP post transaction. Next attribute is the name. This attribute denotes the name of the form, correct? Next attribute is the target. Targets, it's a set the name of the target window, or you can say frame where we want to display the result. So you you can add the values like blank, self, present, etc. So this blank is a open a new window, self is a open the same frame. It is when you click that one. Parent, open a parent frame set. Top, open a full body of the window. And a frame name is open in a name of frame. Okay. There are some controls also in a form. First control is the text input control. Second one is the checkbox control. Then radio buttons control, select box control, file upload boxes button control, and hidden from the hidden form field. So when we talk about this control, we can say this elements of that form or form controls. First is the input text control. So what is the syntax of that, and how can we declare this text input in our form or in our web page? For that, you open firstly form tag. In the form tag, you declare your form. Open form tag. In that form tag body, you enter some input tag using the input like one line. It is a one line of user input. So it's a created using HTML input tag. So input type equal to text. Text word is in a double quotation. Name equal to text user. Okay, what you want to give that name? You can also change that name. For password input control. Oh, so let me tell you, text input have three types. First one is a single line text input. Second is a password input, and third one is a multi line text input. So in a single line text input, you give the input type as I told, text and name. Second, which we discuss about the password input control. This is a two single line text input control. Expect that is mask the character when user enter it, and it's also created in an input type. So input type equal to password, name equal to text pass. So there are some attributes of that input type. So first one is the type, name, value, size, and max length. When you declare some input type for radio buttons checkbox, so you use that attribute. So type is a specify the type of control, and second thing is the name is a specify the name of that control which sent to the server. It is recognize or retrieve that value. Okay. So for that, you using the input type equal to text box and that text box name, or text type equal to radio and name of that radio buttons. Okay. If you want to send the checkbox, so you use the input type equal to checkbox, name equal to checks Phoenix. Okay. So in this way, you can use this HTML form control. So using form, you can give the user form like you want username, about some user information, username, user address, phone number, email ID. So in that time, you use this form element, okay? There are some also buttons available, submit button, reset button, and buttons. So normal button, you can use the submit button for the submission. This button submit a form. Second, reset button. This button reset it's used for the clearance. So this button reset or clear from the controls. It's initially blank. When you click on that button, the all content of that your text boxes, radio buttons, or check boxes which you already selected, it will be clear and it's reset again. Third button is a only type is a button. So this button calls a client side scripting function. Okay. When you talk about the file, fifth number, file upload boxes. So this is used to give the option to the user for a file upload. This is created using the input tag. Type attribute set is a file. So attribute is accept, and this is the describe, or we can say specify the type of the file that servers accept. Okay. So last one is the hidden form field. This element is used to hide the data while sending it to the server. This control, as name suggested, does not display on the form. So in next lecture, we will create one form using this all HTML form controls. Okay. So we already discussed all details about the form. Next lecture, we will see some programs about forms. So let's stop today's lecture. Thank you.